Good evening, East Africa. Welcome to yet a brand new week of the desk, and also exciting one. Now more than ever, I am yours truly, Shadrach Shagaf Kisame. Now, thank you very much for always keeping yourselves glued onto U24 television. I tell you, every time you watch U24, you're inspired, you're motivated, and above all, you're educated. Now, like tonight, actually, it's going to be somewhat a very inspirational episode, as you're going to be inspired by a lady. Now, the lady in the chair, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Kemigisha Noelin. Now, I must admit, when I was on social media, specifically Snapchat, I usually never post, but I go there to check to see what you people are posting, what is going on, what is trending. I continuously watched her work. She's an interior designer, but she also has a workshop in Chevando. She actually does the furniture work herself. You see her with a drill, you see her with a hammer, you see her with a claw hammer, with the nails, she gets hands-on. Actually, the first time people were telling me about her, I thought they were lying. But nonetheless, Noel Kemigisha is on the show to inspire the girl child down there. Welcome to the show, Noeline.
Hi, Shuki.
Good to see you in person.
Thank you.
How long have we talked online?
Oh, like 4 months.
Like 4 months? Touch me, am I real? She was telling me she just watches me on TV and online, but here we are now. Now, Noeline, tell us, did you study this in school? Is it a passion? How did you end up in interior designing, and specifically the woodwork that you do in the workshop?
First of all, I studied it, but mm-hmm. Second of all, which is the main point, is that my grandfather was a carpenter.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and my uncles inspired me.
Okay.
Yeah, so I've grown in it, I've grown with it, mm-hmm. She has paid my tuition, she has paid everything. So I grew to love it and to believe I can be like them and more and more and more.
So you actually love this thing?
I love it with passion.
So how about the girls that are actually the producer and the Slay Queen? We have Slay Queens, and for them they can't. Talk to a girl out there.
You know, every job that you get or everything that you do, you just have to put in passion.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from interior designing, me, when I was at campus, I would do marketing, I would work in the bars, I would promote companies, I would promote products. But still, at the end of the day, I would go back to my books and go back and do my work.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Even those that know me personally, they know I'm a party person. But the party person me, I used to be working.
Okay.
All the projects I would do, it was actually work. And then afterwards, my real me was always passion to be an interior designer and more.
So now, when did you graduate?
I graduated in 2020 in January.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you're always busy.
Yeah.
How do you get these gigs?
I don't know. I post. Sometimes I get them from Snapchat.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I get them from, you know, even when I was in high school, even when I was in campus,
mm-hmm.
I would do still market, you know, still post the things that I can do and things that I love doing.
Mm-hmm.
And people would always make their orders. So those people kept on saying, hey, that girl does this, that girl does this. So some knew me or know me since then. They keep on sending my number to other people.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So let's talk about COVID.
Yeah.
COVID has affected everyone. Yeah. Now, you had just graduated on fire, ready to work, and then boom, COVID. Tell me, how did you handle it?
First of all, when I graduated, the following day, I just got my drill. I never had a workshop. I got my bag, I got my drill, and I went to industrial area. That was one.
Just walking into industrial area with your drill?
I just walked with my drill in my bag. And I said, I have to get a place to work from.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know anyone.
Mm-hmm.
Only the people that I'll meet when buying materials, and they're like, hey, now we call even having to, now the engineer.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, And then they're like, hey, you can work with us, by the way. What? Then there was a gentleman who saw me then. I had a project in school. My friend connected me to his mother, and it was a school. So they wanted me to do partitioning and all that. So I called this guy, and I'm like, let's work together. So the fact that I introduced him to work with me, when I work, he's also making money, right?
Okay.
So he told me, you can work at the workshop. I have no problem. You can just be giving me like current, you know? And I'm like, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as I started seeing the flutes or the money coming, like,
Clients just walked in. Sorry. Clients just walked in, or how did you do it? How did you get clients in that short period for you to be able to fit your rent?
I kept posting.
Social media.
Actually, I've never got a client walking in and telling me, hey, I want you to do for me this. Mm-hmm. I want you to do for me a TV stand.
Mm-hmm.
No. I've got clients through social media.
Mm-hmm.
They some find me from the site. They're like, oh, you do this? Mm-hmm. Okay, give me your number.
Mm-hmm.
Then I give them, then they. That's how I get clients.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah. But I'm grateful for the social media. I'm grateful for my friends who keep posting me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then the corona thing.
How did it affect you? When you were in total lockdown. But you guys were not closed.
Closed. Actually, the day they closed us, mm-hmm. I was working at Africana. Mm-hmm. I was doing still gypsum partitioning in Africana.
What is gypsum?
Gypsum is a board. Mm-hmm. It's like made out of paper and some clay that is white and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But we use it for ceilings, designs on ceilings, mm-hmm. or partitioning offices,
mm-hmm.
Or TV wall hanging TVs. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's what they use in gypsum. It's called gypsum ceiling, gypsum design.
Oh, you were at Africana?
Yeah, so I was at Africana that mm-hmm. day. They had locked us down, but mm-hmm. then they had left the transportation, yeah?
Yes.
So that day, mm-hmm. I was getting done with mm-hmm. the site.
Mm-hmm.
And I just got the contract, but I was getting done, you know, like it's always a 4-day work, 5 days, 6 days, mm-hmm. at most 6 days.
Mm-hmm.
Then they announced on TV and they're like, starting at 7,
mm.
no bodaboda. Actually, bodaboda is already cancelled. Mm. No cars.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're in a car, only 3.
Mm-hmm.
And we're 4 people. And you didn't have a car even. I had to call my client and he told me, you know what, Kisha? And now those things weren't in the money. What? Why making my life hard? The transportation. And I'm like, oh God, what am I going to do? I'm like, I can't leave my what? Mm-hmm. My boys at the site.
Exactly.
I rather stay and they go home.
Yes.
So he came and picked us and we were five in the car.
Wow.
So when we reached at Ginger Road there, the roundabout,
mm-hmm.
we saw the police with Chiboko. Like they're hitting everyone.
Mm-hmm.
So this I told this guy, do you mind jump out?
Mm.
Walk up like
Oasis to
find in. The guy jumped out very fast.
Mm-hmm.
And then we survived.
That's how you survived?
That's how I survived. Then we first went in front, then we picked him and then took him back home. Goodness. Oh my God.
COVID.
And then that site, I stopped that day. So all the money I had saved, that's the time I had actually paid my rent. Like mm-hmm. I had left hostel because when I was working, I was in hostel. After mm-hmm. school, I kept on staying in hostel.
Mm-hmm.
So I had just paid my rent. I had just upgraded my phone during that period. And I'm like,
like now, a typical progressing girl.
Yes.
Mm.
Yes. Now I'm like, now COVID. What am I going to do? My savings has already gone mm-hmm. somewhere. Now they say no movements, rent, which I'm like, now my landlord calls, I'm like,
What am I going to do?
But I'd already given him money. I told him, you know what, you have to wait for me. Just like others.
I know.
And he was actually patient. He waited. And then during COVID, I didn't know.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I didn't know that after COVID, I would have what to do.
Mm-hmm.
But during COVID, mm-hmm. after 2 weeks, mm-hmm. I started getting orders. Because me, I kept on posting my what?
Exactly.
Work.
Because I kept following you and as like, seeing you working.
I first got pissed. Mm-hmm. Like, I first came down. I'm like, oh God. But I felt so down. I'm like, 1 week. The second week, I'm like, no.
Mm-hmm.
This is the time
mm-hmm.
to show people that actually you can get anything you want after COVID.
Okay.
And you know, during COVID, it's when you realize you didn't have a sitting chair, you didn't have a stool, you need like a flower in the corner, you know?
Because you have too much time on your hands.
You have too much time actually at home to sit down. So during COVID, I started getting orders.
Mm-hmm.
Kisha,
can you do this?
I want you to do for me this. How much would you do it for me? I calculate, I give them the quotation online. Can you do this? I'm like, yes, I can do it. I calculate, I give them quotation. So when they release social workers like this,
mm-hmm.
my dear,
You said now actually
I started working and I was like grateful to go ahead actually
on that point of after COVID.
Yeah,
I'm going to go for a short break, but when we come back you take us through after COVID. I know, I also want to ask you about your cabaret trip that you just posted
online. It's actually solo.
Okay, now do not go away. We are still on the continent's leading intellectual platform, actually the highest platform for solution finding, The Desk. We are still at Nile Avenue UBC headquarters and we are live. Do not go away. And welcome back to the second segment of this very lovely episode of The Desk. Actually, if you've just joined us, I'm afraid you missed the very first insightful segment of The Desk, where we are with Miss Noeline Kemigisha. I tell you, this is actually a very inspirational episode because the girl child talking to you is actually in our age bracket. She told you she started working when she was still at campus and she was in hostel. And her first kamane, as you call it, she went and rented. Now, you can follow this very lovely discussion on our social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Do it for Shadrach Kisame and do it for U24 Television. Now, the number on your screen is for you to feature on The Desk or to advertise. Do not call me wanting to talk to Miss Noeline. Miss Noeline, are you on social media? How can people find you?
Through Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
Kisha Creatives.
Kisha Creatives.
Yes.
So they just go there, place their orders right there?
They get my contact, then they can WhatsApp me, call me, and then make, yes.
All right, so we're talking, actually, was it this week or last week? I saw you posting, you did like a whole building in Kabale. What were you doing? What were you even doing? How do you even get those deals, man? Abantu babona bona tuli mu struggle for you having jobs.
Actually, it was Kisoro.
Oh, Kisoro.
And, yeah, and then how I got that job is, a client met me at a site doing gypsum sealing, and he told me, are you an artist? And I'm like, yes, I'm an artist. Mm-hmm. I don't want these .com things. I want my house to have my hotel. Actually, it's an upcoming
hotel.
Like
a hotel. Yeah, it looks like a hotel.
I want it to have nature. I want it to have art. Mm-hmm. And then I'm like, what do you want to use? He told me, I want you to play with my mats.
Mats. Oh yeah, I saw the brown ceiling. Yes. Mm.
So I got him through a client.
Mm-hmm.
And then the following day he told me, can you come and take measurements? And I'm like, I don't have transport. Moving from Kampala to Soro is costly.
Mm.
And he's like, no, don't worry, I'll pay your transport, your accommodation, and you come and take the quotation. And then and I'm like, oh, nice.
Oh, wow.
And actually the fact that I had family there, so I went there.
Oh, wow. Talk to someone who is looking for such gigs. What should they do?
You should believe in yourself,
mm-hmm.
you know. And a gig or a job will not come from heaven to fall on you.
Mm-hmm.
It has to come from the place you are. Mm. Either you're working somewhere and then a better thing comes on your way.
Job on job.
You can't jump from nursery and you go in P7.
Correct.
It's step by step.
Correct.
Yeah. So you just keep hustling. You may be doing, maybe you do fashion, but then you can do maybe gowns and what.
Mm-hmm.
Someone will get to know that you do that when they find you doing something that is close to what?
Mm-hmm.
To that. But you can't be an interior designer, yet you're a lawyer.
Okay.
Yeah.
It has to make sense.
Yeah, you have to just keep going, keep hustling.
Mm-hmm.
Keep making new friends. Don't get scared of the age. Actually, I don't get scared of talking to an old man or an old woman.
Because they're the ones who have the contracts.
Yeah, and even boda men. You know, those guys can have just, you be like, hey, Java is able. Hey, Katia, what boda? You start conversation and it's like, hey, you never know who you are talking to.
But girls of your age, the ones actually look like you. For them, they don't want to talk to a boda. I mean, by low class.
It's because of maybe they're still seeing life at a...
Oh, all right, so let's just maybe, for instance, if I know you're not in politics, but what do you think government can do to help people like you? In Cheva and Do and your workshop, what do you think government can do to enhance people in that kind of workspace?
One thing I think about, when I think about that, it's like government should actually give the youth.
Mm-hmm.
As in, I don't know, how should I say it?
Incentives or something?
No, like, you know, when we are paying, when you are buying these materials, the taxes, what, oh, what?
Okay.
They should actually reduce on some taxes, and they should make groups for, like, they always say, make a group, go to the bank, they'll give you a loan. Make a group, but when you reach there, they ask you LC chairperson, da 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 da. You can even.
Have you tried going to get a loan?
I've actually tried.
In a bank?
Yeah, but I just asked information. I fear loans, but actually I need them.
You need a loan. So,
you're
talking to government because your national television and government officials actually watch. Mm-hmm. The other day someone called me and was like, you're saying government, we are not working, what? They so should, government officials work.
They should support the youth. They should, that money they say that we pay 10,000 every month to what? Mm-hmm. For COVID, what? Mm-hmm. No, they shouldn't do that to us. Actually, they should actually send some command on our accounts so that we can build ourselves.
Government doesn't have that money.
Government doesn't have that money. Mm-hmm. But we put it there and they take it. Where does it go?
Where does it go?
Yeah,
roads. But, you have roads?
We have roads, but still.
Healthcare,
everything
centers.
I do has taxes. The nail for 100, the what, the drill, the everything.
Actually, tell us, take us through your typical day. You wake up and go to the, what do you do in a workshop? Like, you don't look like someone who is in a workshop, apart from me who has seen you in a blue overall. Like, tell us about your typical day in the workshop.
My typical day, I get up at 6. Mm-hmm. I first see my phone, if I got an order or call or someone, if I had an appointment, I check, I make my, I shower after showering, I go to the workshop immediately. That's when I begin planning. I say, okay, today I was supposed to do this. I do the cutting list.
What is a cutting list?
If someone wants, let me say a wardrobe and I took the measurements, I sit down, I calculate, because interior designing or carpentry, anything that is artistic, it needs a calculations. You have to be, you know,
the measurements need to be accurate.
You have to be accurate, cause so that you may, so that you don't make losses.
Okay.
Yeah, so I make the cutting list, then I go cut them, give them some guys, because I have some people.
That's what I was going to ask you before you actually continue with your typical day. You employ young men and young men. How many do you have on your staff, like regularly when you get a gig? Or you have a guy in Gavameka, the ones that you employ?
Like I can be with four.
Five people under you and you pay them?
Yes. And I feed them and I transport them.
How hard is that? Is it easy or is
I
it
I don't
hard?
Know how I do it too. But I believe, I believe that I can do that and more.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah. And you just graduated this year?
Yes.
Before COVID, and you already have people who are depending on you for, because those people have families, and they're all looking at you.
Yeah. You know, this life, you can be there, and then for you, you are struggling to make 1 million. But the other guy here is struggling to make 10,000. Umuntu wa wansi. And those are the people who come to you and they're like, auntie, they come, the sanding guys, the people who do sanding, they give
what
you...
What is sanding?
Sanding, finishing, giving you your products when it's well, neat, sanded, finished. The people who do that are people who, maybe they went to school, but they mimoja Ghana. Maybe they like what they are doing. Maybe they didn't have what to take. Yeah, but... They believe in you, first of all. After believing in you, they trust you. After trusting you, they come and work for you. Even if you tell him, Nina Kalimu, but I don't have money very well.
Okay.
You come and work. You come and work.
Okay, so as we go for a short break, I want you to talk to Omuntu Awansi, who is down there, about the ones who work for you. Maybe someone is down there, maybe in Chibuli Chikuwa Mutwe, somewhere down there. Banonyeza Emiri Mjibuze. What should they do?
One thing they should do is trust God, be faithful, be grateful to God in everything that He does, provides for you. Another thing, believe in yourself. Starting a job doesn't need you to have 10 million, doesn't need you to have 100. It just needs you as a person. You are the one who starts it, yeah? So you may not have actually money, but you know what to do.
Okay.
Go somewhere, or stand somewhere like, by the way, I can make passion fruits.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Tell the person you can do the passion fruits, he'll give you the job.
With my degree.
With your degree. At the end of the day,
mm-hmm.
that passion fruit person will talk nicely about you.
Mm-hmm.
Never know, one time or another time, say, oh, another, any time a person will come saying, hey, I'm looking for this person, that person, like, nina yamu wala wangi. Yeah? Then they connect you like that. Just believe yourself, wake up, know that today I want to get a job,
mm-hmm.
but how can I get a job? Maybe mm-hmm. you don't have degree, you don't have papers.
Mm.
Look for the place that you know that at least there is something to do. Even if to stand and sell tomatoes on the road, do it.
With how good looking I am.
Actually, let me tell you one thing, the challenge I got.
Mm-hmm.
After campus like this, mm-hmm. MTN,
mm-hmm.
I was among the pulsers. We started the pulse.
Yes, MTN pulse. Mm.
So,
mm-hmm.
they told us to wear our gowns and stand on the road. I was among those children.
So, you stood on the road with your gown?
With our gown. But it was...
How much did you make?
1.2.
Oh, wow.
For 30 minutes.
Oh, wow. That was good.
But do you know, people kept on saying, how can she stand on the road? Is she okay? We shall beat her. So
just for standing on the road with your gown, you made 1.2 million.
I made 1.2.
Okay, on that note, before we get excited, let me go for a short break. When we come back, we start exactly there as we wind up the show. Now you're still a lovely audience. Do not go away. The desk returns in a bit. Welcome back to the last segment of this very lovely episode of The Desk, actually, where we're discussing more of an inspirational story. You know, we're talking about woodwork, carpentry, the life of a lady who actually just graduated this year, but she's having gigs, and actually that's what catapulted me to call her to talk to you down there, who is disillusioned, who actually thinks that there is no light at the end of the tunnel. I tell you, there's light at the end of the tunnel. And if you just follow what some of these tips that the guests on the desk actually tell you. Now, if it's Wednesday, it's all about the desk. Now, if you're watching, you better sit back, relax, better lean forward, or even stand up, because this is the last segment of Miss Noeline Kisha. So, Miss Kemi Kisha,
yes.
Why did you get it to Kisha, like Kisha Creatives? What inspired that?
I just liked it.
You just said Kisha Creatives.
Yeah, Kisha. My friends used to call me Kisha. I had a best friend in all level. She called me Kisha. So she told me it should be my signature name. And she's called Sandra, actually. Okay, I still remember her.
So Sandra, they just said hi. You'll be surprised that Sandra is watching. All right. So let's... we were just talking to a girl child down there who thinks, okay, I'm too good or I'm too of a high standard to do such kind of a job. You stood on the road with your gown after graduation. Your family was watching. Everyone was watching for MTN Pulse for 30 minutes, and they gave you 1.2 million.
Yeah.
My goodness. What was the feel? Everyone was calling you and telling you, are you mad?
Yeah. Messages on my group, campus group, lecturers, they said a lot. But one thing I told my father, the senior mamilimo.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I never say anything as long as I'm going to get paid. And I know every time I'm getting a job, I call my father, call my mother.
Mm.
Sometimes I call my grandmother. I tell them, I'm going to Nyege Nyege, but I'm going to work.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to MTN, but I'm going to work. You may see what, you may see pictures, you may see what, but I'm going to work.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I may have the fun, but I'm still what?
I'm still working.
Yes.
Provided, like I always tell people, provided... the outcome is income, call me.
Yes. So when my father saw that, even on Twitter, it went viral, by the way.
I remember the MTN Pulse girls that were on the road, yes.
But it was a movement. So I was trying to market something like after a camp, but what next?
What next?
Are you going to do?
Mm-hmm.
So I told my father. When I told my father, then people started saying, "Where is this you? Why are you doing this?" My father told me, "Don't worry.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what you are. You are. You yourself. Go away, money.
Go away, money.
Yeah. Mm. So as long as my father believes in me, my mother believes in me, my grandmother believes in me, my aunties and uncles and my siblings,
mm-hmm.
I'm okay.
So that girl there, yeah, Nyomi Midimo, Ali maybe Agamba Anzenze Sola, I can't do that.
Yeah.
Talk to them like in a good way. You know you girls have to say, Mwera gara ganyo. No, talk to them in a good way.
My dear sisters, my dear friends, one thing I can tell is Tonyoma Midimo. However bad, however good it is, never say, I can't work for 200, I can't work for 100. Because you need that 100 shillings to make 1,000.
But you know, Kisha, then also, employees are exploiting people.
Yeah.
Employees are exploiting people. Sorry about Gamba, I can't work for 200. I'm worthy more than
but
that.
But you know, before campus, before graduating actually, before campus I worked also, I was working for 200 per month as an office administrator. But I would do artistic things. Shirts, books, what. And they're paying me 2 months. And I was coming from Mundeje and Teve Road to Sapolo Kagwa.
You were literally working for transport.
I was just working for 50 bob. Take home. But I didn't give up because it gave me a step forward. It gave at least I got to know people in Nasawad. So if you think they're overworking you and you're getting little pay, don't give up because someone has seen you there.
Okay.
So tomorrow when you're working somewhere, you'll be like, come, let's work here. You can do this. I worked as a manager at Yami's. Before graduation, I'm like, let me first work for people. Because after graduation, I want to go where?
To self-employment.
I went, they told me 650 per month. And I'm like, I want 700 at least. The guy said, no. But I didn't like the way they treated us. No lunch, no breakfast, what. I'm like, no. When the first month down, the second month, I was like, no, not really. This is not me.
This is not
I can
me.
Do better.
I can do better than this.
Then I just said, no, you know what? I've resigned. I just resigned like that. And I first did the gemstone, first did the club. Because those night gigs, they would pay me 150 per night. In a week, I work like 4 times.
But you know those things are seen as about abakolera, emyenge, mubera, but you're seen as miscreants.
Yeah, I get. That's what people say, but
are there decent girls working in those things?
Yes.
Because first of all, the dress code alone.
Yes.
The dress code alone,
Truth, know what you're saying, but you have to know what you want.
Okay.
Do you think those people who sell alcohol in the bar, they want? They don't want, but they know what they want. You have to know what you are. I may put on something up to here, but at the end of the day, I know I'm not what you think.
Okay.
You may just, don't judge a book by its cover.
Okay.
Actually, that's the best saying.
Correct.
Don't judge a book by its cover because you may judge me incorrect, yet deep in me, I'm very...
You're different.
But you see me, I have dreads, I have nails, I have what... You're like, eh, kanakawala kasege. But at the end of the day, when I go home, they're like, oh, welcome back home.
My daughter.
They change you.
You know our time is really fast spent. People need to watch the movie after. We don't want to enter in the movie in the movie time. There people are just waiting. Shadrach, the show is nice, but the movie is coming up next.
Yeah, I get.
So, where do you see Kisha Creatives in 5 years?
I feel it's going to be a big thing. I don't know, but I see it big.
Let's say you are the president of East Africa, 5 countries combined. What would you do first?
I don't know. It's too much. I think being a leader is also not easy.
But what would you love to do first? Let's say you were there. Yeah, you were actually there and you're the president.
I would first decorate the whole city.
Okay. Your last words to the girls watching you down there who think, oh, that one is lucky. Oh yeah, Libulunji. Talk to them as you wind up.
I'm just like you. I'm also just like that girl who wants to have nice hair, nice one. But I first suffer and then I get what I want. Because you can't get water from a rock before, you know,
you squeeze it.
So all the girls there, believe in yourself. Don't give up in what you want. If you sell clothes, do it with passion. Show people that you love it, you're interested. Give people time, give clients time. Don't give up, just stay focused.
Most of the
know what you want and don't spend all the money that you make. At least spend something and then save something and invest it in something else.
Well, like how she has told you, do not spend most of the money. Actually, and most of the guys, first of all, at work, mwina attitude. Mm. You just want to be on social media. Yeah. Address that.
At work, they are an attitude, as in how?
Like, things of ingira muduka. What do you want?
Yeah, actually, the one thing that sells is the attitude you portray to people.
Mm-hmm.
For me, I can't buy a shoe from a person who's like, what do you want? No.
Mm.
But the attitude you give gives a picture of you. But when you come smiling, me, I meet people and I smile. Even if they abuse me, I smile.
Mm.
But at the end of the day, I come like, why did he even abuse me?
Okay.
But then I don't show the other side of me.
Mm.
You have to show the good part of you to get clients. Oh. Clients are like babies.
Mm-hmm.
You hold them like a glass.
Like a glass. Until you get what you want.
Until.
Thank you very much for coming to the show, Miss Kisha.
Thank you so much.
Miss Kemigisha Noeline, right there for you. Now, you've been a lovely audience. Tonight has been very inspirational. The young lady has told you what to do, what not to do. She has told you what has helped her, so you can pick a leaf or two. Now, from me and the entire U24 management, we'd like to sign out. We'd like to say good night, good luck, adios for God and my country, and may the good Lord bless this beautiful Uganda. Until next week, same place, same time. Good night.